Dear students, welcome back to the course Electronics Engineering. We have already discussed in first lecture the introduction of operational amplifiers, their modes of operations and use of and significance of differential amplifier in the block diagram of operational amplifier. In this lecture, we are going to cover the op-amp parameters and ideal op-amp. So, we are going to start lecture 2 of unit 4, operational amplifier. The first parameters which we are going to define is open loop differential voltage gain. The open loop differential voltage gain is the gain with which operational amplifier amplifies the difference of two input signals. We are going to the first parameter which we are going to start is open loop differential voltage gain. Open loop voltage differential gain is the gain with which operational amplifiers amplifies the difference of the two input signals. It is denoted as A suffix D. D is for differential voltage gain, normally where AV is the voltage gain or open loop voltage gain of operational amplifier. AD is defined as the ratio of output voltage upon differential input voltage and is denoted as AD is equal to output voltage VD upon differential voltage VD. That is, VD is the difference of two input voltages V1 and V2. The second parameters is common mode voltage gain. It is defined as the average of the two input signals and is known as common mode signal. That is, VC is V1 plus V2 upon 2 and voltage gain AC is defined as the ratio of the output voltage V0 upon the common mode signal VC. There is one important point is here that the gain with which op-amp amplifies the common mode signal to produce an output is called common mode gain. Therefore, if we are going to find the total output, it will be the gain voltage due to differential voltage gain and plus common mode voltage gain, that is V0, yeah, total output voltage of any differential amplifier is the differential voltage gain multiplied by difference signal upon common mode voltage gain AC multiplied by common mode voltage signal. In all the practical purposes, since VC is ideally 0, because the same input signal is applied to the both the input terminals. So, VC is equal to V1 minus V2 is equal to 0, because V1 and V2 are same voltage signal available at both the input terminals. So, in all the practical purposes, we can say that V0 of an operational amplifier is given as AD VD. Unless or otherwise it is specified that we have to take in the consideration the common voltage gain and common mode signal. Now, we come to the third parameters, that is CMRR. This is an important parameter used to for the all practical purposes to know how the common mode signal is rejected. The ability of a difference amplifier to reject common mode signal is expressed by the ratio called common mode rejection ratio. As we have already seen, the voltage gain, differential voltage gain and common mode voltage gain, it is simply the mod value of the differential voltage gain upon common mode voltage gain, and it is denoted as rho. Generally, AC, common mode voltage gain, is very small, and AD, differential voltage gain, is very large. Therefore, the value of CMMR is very, very large. So, to express it in generally, AC is very small and AD is very large. Therefore, the value of common mode rejection ratio is very large and normally expressed in decibels, and it is defined as 20 log mod value of AD upon AC, means differential voltage gain upon common mode voltage gain. The higher the value of the CMMR, the better is the ability of the op-amp to reject the common mode voltage, such as electrical noise. This is the property, that's why op-amp are used in all the practical purposes circuits, which are used such as communication, computation, etc. The fourth property, which we are going to discuss here, is output offset voltage. We know, since op-amp amplify the difference signal available at both the input terminals, ideally if both the input terminals are grounded, the output should be 0. But it is not possible in all practical op-amp circuits because of the imbalance in the transistor characteristics. So, the value which we get in the case when both the input terminals are grounded is known as the offset voltage. Next is input offset voltage. As we know that there should be 0 output output offset voltage will be available, yes, should be available in case of ideal op-amp circuits, but in all practical purposes we get some value, although it is very, very small. So, to remove this output voltage, the voltage which is applied to the input terminals to nullify this output offset voltage is known as the input offset voltage. We have seen how it can be represented in the given circuit 4.8b. This is the voltage, that is VDC1 minus VDC2, which is to be applied so that at the output we get 0 or null voltage. Next parameter which is of importance is input offset current, and it is represented at I suffix IO, input offset, and I is for current. It is defined as the algebraic difference between the currents flowing into the two terminals of the operational amplifier. As we have already seen, if we recall in first lecture, the differential amplifier circuit, the two input terminals are IB1 and other is IB2. So, in case of imbalance transistor, we get some value which is non-zero and it is known as input offset current and is represented as IB1 minus IB2. And in case of operational amplifier, as shown in the figure, these are the two currents which are flowing to the non-inverting input and inverting input. IB1 is the current flowing through the non-inverting input terminal and IB2 is the current flowing to the inverting input terminal. Next parameter is input bias current. Input bias current is the average of the current flowing into the two input terminals of operational amplifiers, that is IB1 and IB2. It is simply the average of the two inverting and non-inverting current flowing through the open terminals. Next parameter is slew rate. Slew rate is defined as the maximum, you should note that it is the maximum rate of change of output voltage with time. That is, slew rate is rate of change of voltage with respect to time, but this rate is maximum rate of change and it is not expressed in volt per second, but it is expressed in volt per microsecond. This point is also to be noted that it is expressed in volt per microsecond, the time, the rate of change of voltage with respect to time when time is measured in microsecond, and it is maximum rate of change. The importance of this is that it shows how rapidly the output of an operational amplifier can change with the change in input frequency. If input voltage varies faster than the slew rate, output will not vary over the full expected range and the signal will be distorted or we get a clipped signal. And the last parameter is gain bandwidth. In op-amp case, in the case of operational amplifiers, the unity gain frequency and cutoff frequency are related by the expression F1 is equal to differential voltage gain multiplied by the cutoff frequency, that is bandwidth. Unity bandwidth is equal to differential voltage gain multiplied by the cutoff frequency. It is also represented by B1, that is bandwidth, unity gain bandwidth. As the frequency of the input signal increases in the case of operational amplifier, the gain drops off until it finally reaches to the value of 1. The frequency at this gain value is specified as unity gain bandwidth B1, and the other frequency of interest is that at which gain drops by 3 decibel or 0.707 times gain, and this frequency is known as the cutoff frequency of the operational amplifier. These two frequencies are related by the expression B1 is equal to AV multiplied by FC. with after discussing different parameters of the operational amplifier, we can now define the ideal op-amp, how these parameters can be related or expressed in ideal op-amp and how it varies in practical op-amp. So, on the basis of the parameters, we studied the ideal op-amp characteristics can be summarized as follows. First, the gain of an ideal op-amp is infinite, the input impedance of an ideal op-amp is infinite, the output impedance of an ideal op-amp is 0, the output voltage will be 0 when the input is 0, that is the offset voltage is 0 for ideal op-amp. Bandwidth of an ideal op-amp is infinite, so it can amplify any frequency signal from 0 to infinite hertz. The slew rate of an ideal operational amplifier is infinite, so that there is no lag between the change in the input signal and output we get at the output. So, that the output voltage changes occurs simultaneously with the input voltage changes, and the CMRR ratio for an ideal operational should be infinite. If any operational amplifier satisfy these parameters, then it is known as an ideal operational amplifier. So, on the basis, as we have seen in the first lecture, we have seen the block diagram of the operational amplifier, we have seen the symbol of the operational amplifier. So, for ideal operational amplifier, we can draw the symbol and circuits as follows. As we have seen, the input impedance is infinite. So, Ri is replaced by Ri is infinite, so it is represented here as open circuit, and R naught is 0, so it is represented by short circuit. R 0 is replaced by a simply short circuit and it is by open circuit. So, V naught can be represented in this case, V naught is equal to A d V d. So, for an ideal op-amp, it is simply the voltage gain, differential voltage gain multiplied by the difference signal. Now, we see how the ideal op-amp circuit differ from the practical op-amp circuit, or what are the different parameters, or what are the values of the parameters in case of operational amplifier. For all practical purposes, voltage gain is of the range of mega ohm, that is 10 to the power 6. Bandwidth will be in the range of megahertz. Input impedance will also be in the range of mega ohm. Output impedance should be or will be in the range of hundreds ohm. Slew rate is 0.5 volt per microsecond, common mode rejection ratio is in the range of 90 decibel, and input offset voltage vary from 1 to 6 millivolt, while in case of ideal operational amplifier, voltage gain is infinite, bandwidth is infinite, input impedance is infinite, output impedance is 0, slew rate infinite, common mode rejection ratio infinite, and input offset voltage 0. Now, we will discuss two examples, so that you can understand how these parameters are used to solve problems and their significance. The first example we are going to take is on common mode rejection ratio. The question is, determine the output voltage of an op amp for input voltage VI1 given as 150 microvolt and VI2 140 microvolt, also given as differential voltage gain as 4000 and common mode rejection ratio is 100. From two provided input voltages VI1 and VI2, we calculate first VD, it is simply VI1 minus VI2, that is 150 minus 140. Are 10 microvolt and common voltage VC is simply VI1 plus VI2 by 2. So, common mode voltage is 150 plus 140 upon 2, that is 145 microvolt. With this, we know that CMRR, that is common mode rejection ratio, is defined as AD upon AC. Here we have the value of AD, we have the value of AD given, it is given. CMRR is given. So, AC can be calculated. We can simply find the value of AC. AC is from this equation AD upon CM. AC is called simply AD upon CMRR. And it is come 4000 divided by 100, that is 40, and total output voltage is given by V naught is equal to ADVD plus ACVC. So, we can calculate the total output voltage as 4000 multiplied by 10 microvolt plus 40 multiplied by 145 microvolt, and it comes to be 145.8 millivolt. Now, we will see next examples, which is an example for calculating the bias current or offset current. So, in this example, we have to calculate the input bias current at each input of an operational amplifier having specified values, that is input offset value 5 nanoampere and input bias current 30 nanoampere. If you recall from the earlier slides, how these parameters are defined. I am simply coming to the previous slides to simply recall you how these input currents, bias currents and offset current are related. We can see that input offset current is the difference of current flowing through the two terminals of the operational amplifier, that is IB1 minus IB2. And input bias current is the average of the current flowing through the two input terminals. With this much of information, we can find the required value. that is I b is equal to I b 1 plus I b 2 by 2 and I naught is equal to I b 1 minus I b 2. Simply, that is I naught is equal to I b 1 minus I b 2 and I b is equal to I b 1 plus I b 2 upon 2. So, using these two equations, we can find the input bias currents I b 1 and I b 2. So, I b 1 can be calculated as I b plus I naught by 2. So, I b 1 from these two equation is I b plus I naught by 2. That is, I b is given as 30 nano ampere and I naught is equal to 5 nano ampere. So, I b 1 is equal to 30 plus 5 by 2, that is 32.5 nano ampere, and similarly I b 2 is equal to I b minus I naught by 2, that is 30 minus 5 by 2, that is 30 minus 2.5, and it comes out to be 27.5 nano ampere. So, in this lecture we have covered the different parameters of the operational amplifier and also discuss the difference between ideal and practical op amp and how ideal op amp is represented, as well as we, with the help of two examples, we have seen how the different parameters can be calculated if one is given or other is known. In next lecture, we will cover what are the ways to solve or design a practical op amp circuits and what are their significance. So, thanks for listening to lecture number 2 on operational amplifier. We will meet next in lecture number 3 to discuss practical op amp circuits and their applications. Thank you.